For most women, labor begins with contractions. They cause the cervix to dilate to about 10 centimeters, allowing your baby to move into the birth canal. As your cervix begins to open, the mucus plug that blocks the cervical opening is discharged into the vagina. Sometimes losing the mucus plug happens days or weeks before labor starts. You might also feel your water break and experience increasing pressure in your back. Despite common misconceptions, only about 15 to 20% of people experience their water breaking before going into labor. Contractions will eventually become more regular, come close together, and last 60 to 90 seconds. For a first pregnancy, the time from the start of established labor to being fully dilated is usually 8 to 12 hours. It's often quicker, around 5 hours in subsequent pregnancies. If you feel the urge to push but are not fully dilated, you will be asked to hold back. Pushing too soon could cause your cervix to swell, which might delay delivery. Pant or blow your way through the contractions. When your cervix is fully dilated, your baby will move further down the birth canal toward the entrance to your vagina. It's time. You may get an urge to push that feels like you need to poo. The pushing stage usually lasts about an hour. At some point, you might be asked to push more gently or not at all. Slowing down gives your vaginal tissues time to stretch rather than tear. After the baby's head has emerged, the body is rotated sideways so that the shoulders can emerge easily, one at a time. The rest of the baby usually slips out quickly after the first shoulder comes out. The umbilical cord is clamped and cut. After your baby is born, you'll likely feel great relief. You might hold the baby in your arms or on your abdomen. Cherish the moment, but a lot is still happening. You'll continue to have mild, less painful contractions. The contractions help move the placenta into the birth canal. You'll be asked to push gently once more to deliver the placenta. The placenta usually detaches from the uterus within 20 minutes. Your doctor will examine the placenta to make sure it's intact. Any remaining fragments must be removed from the uterus to prevent bleeding and infection. The doctor will also determine whether any tears in your vaginal region need stitches. If you didn't have anesthesia during the birth, you'll receive an injection of local anesthetic in the area needing stitches. The stitches will typically dissolve on their own within 6 weeks. Thank you for watching this video. Please watch my next video if you'd like to learn more about the specific stages of labor and delivery.